It's always the establishment picks a candidate in the donor class rallies to that candidate. I know a lot of these guys. I talk to them, and their money's on the sidelines now, but they're just getting ready for Jeb to announce, okay? And then the Wall Street Journal just had a forum the other day, I guess, and they and 76% of the people at the forum wanted Jeb. Okay, so I've said since November 2012, Jeb is going to be the nominee. And people hate me for saying this, but I say it because unless there is one conservative alternative to the establishment, not five, not Ted Cruz, Herman Cain, Ben Carson, Rand Paul, and five others, but one conservative alternative to the establishment always, 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 with an exclamation point, wins. Do you disagree with that?
I don't disagree with that, and I think it's the way it plays out in the primary process. I mean, I remember watching that 2012 battle and looking at those voices and persons on the stage and sitting there going, you know.
None of them were ever going to be president. None of them were going to be president.
Exactly.
Except maybe Santorum if things were done differently. But we have like eight people on the stage, and I'm thinking, what are you doing? You are ensuring that the establishment wins. So I think they should have
divide and conquer.
Yeah, they should have a conservative primary of sorts, whatever we want to call it, elimination round, before the Iowa caucuses, and have concluded one person gets to be the nominee for conservatives and then run against the establishment. I know people think it's not possible to do it. It's the only way to beat the establishment. You are not going to beat it by having five conservatives against Jeb Bush. It's not going to happen.